Hello and welcome to another replay cast of A2K 101. This time, again, surprisingly, in the scores. Tier 7 Russian Cruiser. Yeah. Like last time, also on Two Brothers. Yeah. Why did I choose this game? Yeah. Because I had to carry my team to the victory again. Somehow, the game challenges me the most in the scores to carry the games for my team. Of course, I have a little help of my teammate Prosan, but still, two-man division are not so carry strong like three-man division, for example. But he has a carrier, which is pretty good. So yeah, as mentioned last time, I will proceed around to be here in this area and support my DDs in the early game. The usual stuff. You shouldn't be too close in the scores. You want to go wide as much as you can. Stay on max distance. Maybe use your spotter plane. I think you should know it from the last game. I think I mentioned it. Alright, matchmaking, I think you got a glimpse on it, so let's put it again. Yeah, we have 5 battleships, some cruisers, and 3 DDs, so yeah, I wouldn't say it's balanced, but it's the meta of today, so there are always more battleships than cruisers, for example, so that's in a way quite hilarious if you think about it, but it's how it is, so we have to deal with a lot of HP to burn down. So you all know, Scores is good at burning down battleships and lightly armored targets as well. I didn't shoot because there was not much value out of it if I shoot the Fitchy there. That's... Yeah, now we have this... issue with the replay again. Well, all what I tried didn't help so far. Well, we have to live with it. Okay, yeah, a lot of smoke, and yeah, of course, I didn't shoot the Fitchy because I'm not a battleship. Battleship has much more success in deleting him. I don't wanna give away my position yet to surprise the enemy and... yeah, that's what I did. I'm just practically sitting behind that island and try to farm that Duke of York, who damage cut my first fire. Really smart, Mr. Duke of York. I mean, he has good concealment, understandable, but still... he will burn a lot then. Otherwise, no DD spotted, so I can happily do this. And yeah, the issue is if you go aggressive... I know only from the Duke of York that he is around here, so I don't see any other battleship. Means if that's the only battleship, I can play a bit more aggressive. But there we go, that was the only happy time I had here, because down south, Kneisenau appeared. And also the carrier is getting involved now here at the A-cap, means the times of being not spotted anymore are over. I need to get concealed and turn away and yeah, do the usual stuff. But still, I'm... yeah, that was, by the way, the Kneisenau. I was angled and I thought he even shot HE, so... Doesn't help. I have to bail from this position. I don't want to be stationary at all. And I have a pretty good fire chance at the moment, it looks like. Yeah, I was not paying too much attention and almost crowned it. Which would have led to certain death, that's for sure. Now 2 DDs are up, and now I'm in this bird view, where what I mostly dislike to play with. It doesn't feel so... Well, the handling is not so good. I miss so many shots while doing it. Try to help our Gajamada, but I'm really, really unable to do something. And I can't go closer because the enemy BB is pushed. Our BBs, for whatever reasons, are pissing off. I mean, the King George is still here. He can burn down. But why the New Mexico left is kind of a riddle to me. There was no actual reason. But means that the Krass, Gaja, and myself, plus the King George, are the only one holding this flank. And, yeah, might not be enough against Fiji, Cleveland, Akatsuki. Okay, Kremyashi is dead. And the Kneisenau. So, that's a lot of firepower if they use it correctly. Yeah, and there our Gaja is going down by, for whatever reasons. I don't know. Maybe the Akatsuki spotted him. I am not sure. So far, Prosen is helping out on the other side, that it doesn't go to shit over there, which makes much more sense, I would say. So far, nothing to shoot. That's an issue now. And our King George, who was stationary, gets dropped. But Prosan is bringing the planes towards me, or is trying to corner them. But yeah, here it's kind of a slow pace game. I also can tell you that the Krass is doing a great job here as well in this game. Just for the sake of Prosan in this carrier, I go for the Cleveland and try to burn him down. As quick as possible. One fire, that was easy. The King George is helping out as well. He has two fires already. So you don't want to do this in the Cleveland. You don't go that much in the open. You become immediately target number one. Especially if you stay on range and the enemy is shooting on range, you get... Yeah. Really obliterated over time. Seems as if the King George was already able to put enough fires on it to kill him. Also, I have my priority target counter up, which lead me there to the conclusion that I get focused by one target, but I don't know which one. Main issue for me here is that I'm misspotting. You will see it soon. Yeah. Now I can't see anything. And Prosan is too busy to help out on the other flank that he can spare some planes for me here. So, I mean, not that you can play too aggressive in the scores. But, yeah, without any vision, it's getting even more complicated. See, I'm playing with my speed. Over this long distances, you might think, oh wow, he's broadside. Yeah, kind of. Not really full broadside, but... I'm definitely playing with the speed here, just to juke their shots. Because over this distances, you can just also like go full stop from full speed. And can juke the shells if you stay at max range, or like let's say about like 16 to 17 kilometers. Shell travel time is way too long, that it doesn't matter. If you're of course in closer distances, so like 10 to 12, don't count on that. Then you need to run and gain distance before you do this. Yeah, Katsuki was recently spotted. Our Leander is going to be to help out or maybe protect our cap. Which is smart, but I won't hit the Akatsuki on 16 kilometers. Also, when I'm concealed, I always try to come a bit closer, because if you are like spamming all the time, you get more and more driven away, and you end up on the border, and you're that which limits your maneuverability and your space to maneuver. So yeah, I always want to go a bit closer again to have some space to kite again towards the edge. And that's why you use your mostly your concealment, which was quite close. If you see how close that Fiji sneaked there. Okay, Knais now. I'm always going for multiple target. If you wanna, if I'm setting fires. The reason is just I want to let want to make them feel okay. You have one fire now. I let you go. And then they just repair the fire, and then you just start hammering them again and get two fires or one fire sticking. That's the whole plan behind this. And since you have such fast firing guns, that can go really, really quick. But yeah, Kneisenau is still burning, so no reason for him for me to shoot him. I'm rather shoot this Fitchy, switching to AP to inflict some more damage. You see, I'm really slow, but yeah, okay, now my priority target counter is up, but it seems as if this is Fitchy who's aiming at me. But on this distance, the Fitchy is, yeah. He won't do shit against me. And the Knights now put out the fire, so I'm going to start to set fires again. And how you see, my fire RNG isn't too bad this game. And somehow I don't get the attention. Nah, now he's aiming for me again. But as you also see, my space is quite limited. I have here on the edge. Fitchy is coming closer, so I'm focusing him. And somehow the Kneisenau had the damage gone up, so I need to work on him soon again. Now the Fitchy has a fire. Put it out, and now it's pretty risky what I said, but at this point I realized, okay, I'm so far, I need to play aggressive no matter what happens. So I'm turning full in. I mean, it's a pretty risky move, especially on these distances, but it seemed as if I was just on time. Maisno has a fire, so one HE volley, loading AP for the Fiji. Also note that the Krass is also doing a great job. He's still alive and doing exactly the same like I did. I don't know if he's hitting that that good on this. Yeah, finishing off the Fiji. Somehow Kneisenau already. No, he has a fire. Ah, okay. The Krass two fires means for me I want to inflict more heavy damage. Means broadside means AP means even more damage than fires on these distances. Also, the Kneisenau is pretty low. Should be an easy thing. Secondaries open up on me, I don't care. Now I'm not even bothering sticking to HEs. And next Savo should finish the job. There we go. We get a nice arsonist. Have AP loaded on the broadside Duke of York, since he's really, really soft armored. resetting the cap. Now sticking or going back to HE. Oh, New Mexico is going in. He's really playing the bait. I mean, with the, all the missions that you have to destroy battleships so and so much, it's quite easy to farm damage, kind of. Because all I saw it several times that you don't get too many focus. People are always going for the easy targets. Okay, that New Mexico shows full broadside, that's also a thing. I mean, he's a clearly potato. I think it was the New Mexico that went away from A. So, yeah. Duke of York secures his kill. He got killed by the Decras, and I don't mind, but look out, who's here? The Hiryu. Well, that's a nice chunk of extra damage. And we will use that. I have AP loaded on this. I hope I'm aiming correctly for the Citadel, but I doubt it. But since he's not moving, I'm not sure where... yeah, you see where the smokestack is, and that's where you want to aim for the Citadels. And, oops. Planes incoming, defensive on. Also, I note that I'm going closer to the shore. To limit the options of the carrier to drop me, only from one side. He can't drop me from this side anymore. So the only thing I need to do is to turn hard right if he's going to drop me. Okay. Now we got Vizora, like last game I featured here on the channel. Just shows how extremely good this ship is. When it it's not pressured too hard, that has to be said. Because you don't, you won't, will never like gain 2 million potential damage in this. Because if that is going to happen, you will be dead 3 times or so because of your armor. Sadly, he made it, or he, it was possible for him to launch another squadron, because I didn't go get fires anymore. Okay, but I can dodge these, but he still got another one, and it was like, ah. But that should seal the deal, yep. But I think he automatically arranged this drop. And here I'm a bit... It is an auto-drop. You can make an auto-drop after you died in the carrier. And I think I slowed down a bit too early. Enemy Cleveland is the only ship left. And... yep, Prosan kills him. And we are done. So, what a game, I can just say. This is on my alt account, so no premium. This is all... I mean, only the camo and some flags. That's it. And I earned 350,000 credits, which is a lot. I made 191,000 damage in one of the squishiest tier 7 cruisers. yeah, that's kind of it's kind of hilarious, but yeah. It happened. 381 shells. I mean, wow. Hit, of course. That was kind of a spamming game. 17 fires. I have to say that my fire RNG was definitely really, really good. 16 plane kills, yeah, due to the fact that all the planes hovered after the death above me. 3 ships killed. Witherer, Arsonist, High Caliber. Well, what do you want to have more? And we carried the game, so Yeah, it seems as if the scores is becoming my carry ship number one. Also, whopping amount of 2.9k base XP. I think that was the highest amount I ever had in the scores. I mean, I thought the 2.6 was good, but the 2.9 are even better. I mean, considering this is only tier 7 and we were in tier 5 to tier 7 matchmaking means you don't or you didn't play against higher tier ships, which normally give you more experience. Yeah, in this case, it's definitely a really good result. Oh my god, look at this 16. Why did the carrier only lose planes to both of us? That's interesting. I mean, Prosan even lost the carrier, the fighter battle, it looks like. Or at least more planes to the enemy CV. I think he mentioned also that he played not quite bad, but he didn't strike at all. Don't know, don't know. Yeah, result screen or detailed results. I mean, Kneisenau, Duke, almost 110k damage together. The Fidschi 20k, Cleveland 10k. Yeah, not so much on the DD since I was like pressured away or like forced away to help out my Gajah. But you can't be that close in a scores. That's the main issue. Yeah, mostly fired HE, but in these occasions where you can use AP, I used AP, and you see it, 73 hits, 26,000. That's a lot. 64,000 fire damage. 60,000 is you need for Witherer. Oh, even my secondary battery was inflicting some damage. Yeah, I was in the end I was rather healthy, I have to say. That's usually not the case if you are in the if you survived the battle and you did all you could do in the scores, then you normally have like maybe 2k HP or something, but or you're already dead or whatever. But yeah. In this case, I survived and yeah, had a pretty decent game. So, hope you enjoyed it. If you have questions, just let me know. If you want to know something, whatever, write it below in the comments. Can I else say? Yeah, give it a like if you liked it, whatever. Nevertheless, see you next time. Bye-bye.